I declare the commencement of the ceremony for the conferment of degrees, session 3.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present for the award of the Bachelor of Arts with honors in Liberal Studies as listed in the Convocation Program Booklet.
By virtue of the authority vested in me, I admit every candidate to the Bachelor of Arts with honors in Liberal Studies as listed in the Convocation Program Booklet.
Bu Chie Ling, with distinction.
Congratulations.
Hemalata Muniandi. Imran Hilmi Taufik Hilmi. Law Yuan Yi. Lakshmi Gunasegaran. Lim Ching Ching. Lim Seng Ho, with distinction. Lim Yok Wa. Pierre Long Bing Zing. Shanti T. Ayadore. Sadanandan V. Viswanath Swaminathan. Tan Su Fong. Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present candidates for the award of the Bachelor of Arts with honors in psychology as listed in the Convocation Program Booklet.
By virtue of the authority vested in me, I admit every candidate to the Bachelor of Arts with honors in psychology as listed in the Convocation Program Booklet.
Abirami Kasi. Bella Nace Lopez. Chandran R. Marimutu. Fung Chui Han. Kogilam Subeya with distinction. Lee Mui Cheng with distinction. Lee Sui Ling with distinction. Lim Sui Hyo with distinction. Lutz Lawrence Pereira. Ui Yap Lin with distinction. Roshini Jayasilan Ramesh Chandru. Wong Mei Fong with distinction.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present candidates for the award of the Bachelor of Technology with honors in Computing and Intelligent System as listed in the Program Convocation Program Booklet.
By virtue of the authority vested in me, I admit every candidate to the Bachelor of Technology with honors in Computing and Intelligent Systems as listed in the Convocation Program Booklet.
Chong Yot Woya. Hui Yi Jun. Leong Sai Man. Lim Xin Ling. Lit Hao Tan. Mutumani Saravanan Supaya. Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present candidates for the award of the Bachelor of Technology with honors in Construction Management as listed in the Convocation Program Booklet.
By virtue of the authority vested in me, I admit every candidate to the Bachelor of Technology with honors in Construction Management as listed in the Convocation Program Booklet.
Lau Chi Pan. Lee Hong Yu with distinction. Leong Chen Che. Wee Teck Liang. Woon Chin Sien. Tan Bo Hin. Tian Kim Peng with distinction. Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present the candidate for the award of the Bachelor of Technology with honors in Database Management as listed in the Convocation Program booklet.
By virtue of the authority vested in me, I admit the candidate to the Bachelor of Technology with honors in Database Management as listed in the Convocation Program booklet.
Zuhaira binti Muhammad Mirasa.
Congratulations.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present the candidate for the award of the Bachelor of Technology with honors in Software Engineering as listed in the Convocation Program booklet.
By virtue of the authority vested in me, I admit the candidate to the Bachelor of Technology with honors in Software Engineering as listed in the Convocation Program booklet.
Deng Yi Fang, with distinction. Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present candidates for the award of the Bachelor of Technology with honors in Computer System and Networks and the Graduate Diploma in Database Management as listed in the Convocation Program booklet.
By virtue of the authority vested in me, I admit every candidate to the Bachelor of Technology with honors in Computer Systems and Networks and the Graduate Diploma in Database Management as listed in the Convocation Program booklet.
Chan Siu Chen. Xia Yan Qin. Chong Che Kang. Gan Xiao Ling. Gong Qi Wa. Gu Wei Liang. Tarani Najasegaram.
Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present candidates for the award of the Bachelor of Business with honors in Logistics and Supply Chain Management as listed in the Convocation Program booklet.
By virtue of the authority vested in me, I admit every candidate to the Bachelor of Business with Honors in Logistics and Supply Chain Management as listed in the Convocation Program booklet.
Chen Yi Kwan. Cheng Chun Fu. Chong Choi Fung. Kor Yok Lin. Kuganathan Padmamurthy. Lai Ying Nga. Lam Mui Kun. Li Chi Chiang. Li Xiu Peng. Lim Chen Fei. Lok Pei Poon. Mohammed Hazir Bin Hassan. Mok Bang Kyong. Norlida Binti Soeb. Kwa Le Pin. Theo Hoi Lee. Honorable Vice Chancellor, I present candidates for the award of the Bachelor of Business with Honors in Sales and Marketing as listed in the Convocation Program booklet.
By virtue of the authority vested in me, I admit every candidate to the Bachelor of Business with Honors in Sales and Marketing as listed in the Convocation Program booklet.
Brian Tan Yu Jin. Chen Yang Sheng. Chen Kok Wei. Chang Xiong Win. Fu Ming Hen. Gan Si Ting. Hui Shi Ying. Liu Kok Chow. Lim Phui Kien. Michael Lip Wang Fu. Ong Beng Kong. Tan Li Lin. Te Chai Seng. Teo Xiao Chi. Tian Zi Quin. To Ming Yong. Ang Li Wa. Wong Ker Zin.
Professor Madhulika Kaushik, Deputy Vice Chancellor, Academic Open Distance Learning, Wawasan Open University. Professor Mohandas, Deputy Vice Chancellor, Academic On Campus Learning, WOU, members of the Senate and Management Board, graduates and families, invited guests, ladies and gentlemen. It is a pleasure to add my warm welcome to this third session of the sixth convocation of Wawasan Open University, and to join you in congratulating the graduates whose achievements we celebrate today. We all share the sense of graduating with those receiving their degrees today. Only yesterday, we witnessed the conferment of the Honorary Doctor of Letters degree to that of Sri Dr. T. Devaraj, who is now an honorary alumni of WOU. His illustrious career and outstanding contributions as a dedicated medical practitioner in the area of cancer awareness and palliative care have produced a huge impact on the lives of people and society at large. I should add also that the university is also awarding the Honorary Doctor of Letters degree to Tan Sri Dr. Jamila Mahmud, the founder of Mercy Malaysia. However, owing to her current overseas appointment and heavy work commitment as chief of the World Humanitarian Summit Secretariat based in the United Nations, New York, Tan Sri Jamila is unable to attend this convocation ceremony. She will, of course, receive her honorary degree in a special award ceremony organized by WOU on a later date. Ladies and gentlemen, we have just witnessed the conferment of degrees and graduate diploma to 100 graduates from 10 programs. My congratulations to all you graduates in this hall. To get to this point in your life is an important achievement to which I commend you. All 100 of you out of a total of 377 fresh undergraduates that WOU has produced this year who have successfully completed your study are here with us this morning. And 32 of you have received degrees in liberal studies and psychology, while 27 others received degrees in computing and intelligence systems, construction management, database management, software engineering, and computer systems and network. Another 40 of you received your business degrees in logistics and supply chain management, and sales and marketing, while one graduate was awarded the graduate diploma in database management. For the first time, the university has produced degree graduates from the database management and software engineering programs. And yesterday, a total of 86 first degree graduates had also received their scores. The remaining batch of 191 graduates will be receiving their scores in the next two sessions later on in the day. We are united by a shared sense of pride and achievements. As we share this special occasion together, I would like to take the opportunity to present to you an account of WOU's progress and achievement over the past 12 months. WOU has been gradually growing in strength in terms of number of academic programs and enrollment of new students. The total number of undergraduate and postgraduate programs now stands at 55 programs, including, of course, the 6 full-time on-campus programs that this university is also offering. And all our academic programs are offered through our 4 schools, namely the School of Business and Administration, the School of Science and Technology, the School of Foundation and Liberal Studies, and of course, the School of Education, Languages, and Communications. These combined 55 programs cover such fields as accounting, banking, management, logistics, marketing, construction management, electronics, English studies, liberal studies, psychology, and education. And out of the 55 programs to date, 30 have already been accredited by the Malaysian Qualifications Agency. Another 11 programs are currently undergoing the accreditation process by MQA, and we are confident that they will become fully accredited in due course. This university started with its first intake of 721 open distance learning students in January 2007, and since then, more than 17,000 students have enrolled to study with WOU at one time or another. The students are well supported, not only by our online learning management system and IT facilities, but also through student support services provided by 8 dedicated regional centers and regional support centers located in Penang, Ipoh, Kuala Lumpur, Johor Bahru, Kuching, Bandar Utama, Klang and Subang. And this year we have increased the new student intake time windows from the usual 2 to 4 for the part-time open distance learning programs. And this is to provide more opportunities for adult learners to pursue higher education. And much to our delight, this move has resulted in an increase in the student enrollment number per semester. And we hope this trend will continue. And here I wish to thank all the staff from our regional centers, regional sub-centers, as well as all the staff in the main campus for their unwavering support in taking on the added workload following the introduction of the 4 intake per year system. With regard to WOU's full-time on-campus study programs, which are offered to fresh secondary school leavers, only at the main campus in Penang, and we have been doing this since September 2013. And even that, the student enrollment for the on-campus programs is also climbing steadily. And today, WOU is offering 6 full-time on-campus programs in the areas of accounting, management, banking and finance, sales and marketing, logistics and supply chain management. Of course, the most recent addition is the Bachelor of Technology Honors in Computer Systems and Network Program. Ladies and gentlemen, taking into consideration this year's total of 493 graduates, this university has therefore all in all produced a total of 1,787 graduates so far. And out of the 493 graduates this year, 116 are from the postgraduate programs and 377 from the undergraduate program. Many of the graduates have benefited in one way or another from study grants and scholarships provided by Wawasan Education Foundation. And to date, the foundation has disbursed no less than 6.8 million ringgit to deserving students in the form of study grants, Chancellor's Merit Scholarship, as well as bursary awards. This support will continue in the coming years. You may also wish to know that our Center for Professional Development and Continuing Education provides short, customized courses and work skill training to interested customers from outside the university, for instance, from corporate companies and organizations. Because WOU is a registered HRDF training provider under the Ministry of Human Resources, and therefore employers who have engaged WOU to undertake training of their employees can actually claim back the cost of their employees' training from the Human Resources Development Fund. With regard to training conducted by WOU, just last Monday, at the request of the British Council of Pakistan and the Higher Education Commission of Pakistan, Wawasan Open University organized a 10-day leadership development workshop for the benefit of 23 delegates comprising senior women academics from universities, in fact, from 19 universities in Pakistan. The aim was to expose the participants from Pakistan to effective leadership in the context of universities, leadership styles, gender work-life balance, and developing skills for driving and management change. And prominent female role models from WOU, USM, UTM, even MQA, University of Nottingham, Malaysia, and National University of Singapore were invited to talk on the subjects in the context of the leadership roles they play, and also to share their work experience with the participants at this training workshop. Ladies and gentlemen, on another front, our government wants lifelong learning to become a way of life for all Malaysians. The Ministry of Education has implemented the new student admissions framework, which now recognizes prior learning. And the current practiced open entry admission system for Malaysian citizens who intend to pursue part-time study in ODL institutions in Malaysia will be replaced by the so-called Accreditation of Prior Experiential Learning, or APEL, APEL for short, this new system. And this is an attempt by the government to widen access to higher education. APEL provides an alternative entry point to those who have no formal qualifications and yet wish to pursue higher education in the university. The system assesses and gives recognition to prior learning gained through formal, informal, or even non-formal means. And working closely with the MQA, WOU has been actively pilot testing this new ODL system admission system throughout the development phase. And WOU has assisted MQA in developing the APEL guidelines for admission to undergraduate and master degree programs. And MQA has also appointed WOU as one of two main APEL assessment centers in the country. So those of you or friends and family members who wish to come in through this channel, please come and talk to us. WOU is also introducing Islamic banking and finance as a subject in its MBA programs. As you know, Islamic banking has gained credibility worldwide over the past 20 or more years. The demand for Islamic banking services is rising, and there is now an increasing demand for qualified graduates in Islamic banking and finance in the banking sector in Malaysia. WOU has over the past 2 years been collaborating with the Global University in Islamic Finance, INSEF, in Kuala Lumpur, to develop three ODL courses on Islamic finance. And these three specially designed courses will add to the pool of elective courses being offered by WOU in its Commonwealth Executive MBA program. And starting from January next year, students who wish to learn more about Islamic banking and finance can take these three courses to carry out their master's project in the same field. The university's academic staff has been actively honing their research skills and also presentation skills through our now conventional WOU seminar series. And many of these research projects were funded by WOU's own Institute for Research and Innovation, as well as from international sources. As part of an effort to generate knowledge and understanding of contemporary issues of interest to the public, the university has also established a Center for Dialogue. And the mission of this center is to generate dialogues on contemporary economic development and socio-political issues which affect our society, and also to share these thoughts and ideas with the public. It will serve as a platform to promote civil discussion in a conducive, unbiased, and objective manner, free from partisan politics, single-issue agendas, and overly aggressive activism. A calendar of events is being planned for next year, and this will be announced as when the time comes. On a different front, WOU has been consistently forging partnership with corporate sector under the Value Partnership Program. And so far, 150 companies have become our partners. What this means is the employees of our partner companies will enjoy attractive tuition fee rebates when they choose to study at WOU. WOU has signed agreements with several MQA-accredited academic institutions to establish more learning centers for purpose of expanding its market outreach in townships where it had not penetrated adequately or had any physical presence. We now have three such learning centers, one in Seremban, another one in Prai, and one in Alor Star. Students from this area can now go to these learning centers, which of course are closer to them. And a memorandum of agreement was also signed in May this year with Penang Skills Development Center, PSDC, which allows for the joint offering of new Bachelor of Technology honors in mechatronics program. WOU is able to leverage on the laboratory facilities and PSDC, while the diploma graduates of PSDC can now seamlessly enroll in WOU to pursue a mechatronics degree. Ladies and gentlemen, WOU has reached a stage where it is now venturing offshore to offer its accredited programs and well-developed courses to learners overseas in partnership with trusted open distance learning providers in countries like Botswana, Indonesia, Maldives, Mauritius, Nepal, Nigeria, and India. Many of them actually approached WOU for assistance in the first place. And we are currently exploring the best mode of collaboration come business arrangement with them. For instance, through joint program offerings and revenue sharing, or licensing of programs and courses. We also provide assistance in human resource capacity building. And this form of development bodes well for the university as it reflects the confidence and trust these foreign institutions have on WOU. And while all these are going on, the university has not neglected its corporate social responsibility. WOU has once again contributed as the gold sponsor for the Relay for Life Penang, an event that raises funds for the fight against cancer and aims to increase cancer awareness. Other activities included a blood donation drive in support of a government hospital. Our year two full-time students also raised sufficient funds to help to cover the cost of heart surgery for a 1.5-year-old baby. Likewise, our part-time students, that means students from the ODL programs, also undertook activities to serve the community in the form of projects helping needy students and also helping to clean the environment. Overall, I'm happy to share that the university is presently well on track, progressing steadily ahead while keeping an eye on its finances, ever mindful of the need to achieve all the goals and financial targets set for the year. Of course, we anticipate that new challenges will emerge in the horizon in these uncertain times. But as I have always mentioned and said, as long as we are securely anchored in our fundamental values and in our well-grounded conviction regarding our mission, WOU stands poised, ready to take on any challenge of today and tomorrow. Now, to all the graduates here this morning, once again, I commend you on your fine achievements. The personal competencies that got you here, commitment, tenacity, and open mind to new knowledge, will remain throughout your life. Will remain very important throughout your life. Please nurture them. Each of you has much to be proud of today. You have met the high standards required at this university. The degrees you have received certify your accomplishment in a particular field of study, your analytical and communication abilities, and the creative and critical skills that are the mark of a WOU graduate. It is also very important to remember those who have supported you through university. And I would like to invite you to join me in giving a round of applause for your parents, spouses, family members, and friends. All of whom have made your achievements possible. And I know many of them are sitting here proudly in the audience today. And I hope that you would all remember this day fondly for the rest of your life. As you leave this campus, degrees in hand, know that you are still part of this community, the WOU community. You are still connected with us, for you are about to join the 1,800 or so alumni of WOU. And we are very proud of our alumni and are always eagerly welcoming and applaud news of their accomplishment. We hope you will stay in touch. Some of you might want to continue your higher education by pursuing MBA degrees like the Commonwealth Executive MBA, which, by the way, is the most popular MBA program of this university. Yesterday, in my speech to graduates of the SEMBA and SEMPA programs, I mentioned to them that they have now become members of the 12,000 plus strong community of SEMBA and SEMPA graduates across 11 Commonwealth countries. They should take pride in that. And so you are most welcome to return to WOU to pursue further studies anytime, whether it is for personal or professional advancement. I also hope that all of you will play an active role as alumni, as well as ambassadors of this university. The university still needs your support. And once again, to all of our invited guests and family members of our graduates, thank you for being here with us, to sharing this momentous occasion together. Thank you, everyone, and enjoy the day. I declare the ceremony for the conferment of degrees, session 3, closed.